In this video, I want to talk through a little bit about the course calendar for our class this semester and just kind of some of the things to expect, how to read the information that's presented here. We'll also talk about where to find a lot of the different resources and files that we use throughout this semester. So, first off, the course calendar can be found by clicking on this calendar button over here on the navigation pane on the left side of Blackboard. It'll pull up a screen that looks like this. This calendar should give you an overview of everything that we're going to be doing on every single day of the semester. When are our homework assignments going to be assigned? When are they going to be due? When are different exams? What sections are we covering? When are classes canceled? Everything is listed here. And it's going to be stretched out onto a typical 5-day format, like if we were meeting face-to-face. So it's recommended that you, again, follow the calendar and what is supposed to be done on each day on the day that it's listed. Staying on pace is going to be really important in this class. Falling behind really makes things difficult. So try to make sure that you're scheduling out some time every day to keep on pace with the different things that are listed here. Okay. So if you ever need to know what's going to be done on a particular day of the semester, if you know you're going to be gone a particular day, it hopefully should be really easy to look ahead and see what needs to be done so that you can make sure that you stay on pace and are fully prepared. Now, in addition to this, I'm going to go ahead in this video and talk a little bit about some of these different folders that you see over here on the side. So we have some different unit folders, and these are going to go along with each of our different exams. So in prepping for exam 1, all materials associated with that are in this unit 1 folder. So when I click on this, you'll see a whole bunch of information. I have lecture guides, video lectures, worksheets, and some different files like graphs that are important for us to know, and then some stuff related to that first exam, a study guide, as well as an exam folder with a bunch of information on exams. In the lecture guides and lecture notes folder, again, what I have here is oftentimes going to be a guide, which is an empty blank version of the notes that you should definitely take notes on. Although this is an online class with videos, and it might be tempting to just say, I'm just going to watch the video and not write anything down, that's a really bad strategy. It's going to make things really difficult. Follow along like this was a regular in-class course. You know, so you would have this out, you'd be copying things down, you'd be writing out problems, you'd be pausing to work on problems on your own at times. That's what you want to replicate to make sure that you have as close to an in-class experience as possible. So I have these lecture guides here so that way you can save a lot of time on writing and we can focus more on trying to understand the different ideas that are presented. In addition to this though, I have lecture notes, which is the exact same sheet but just with everything filled in. So in case you're looking for some more detail, or sometimes in the videos I won't fully go through a problem and I'll say to work it through on your own and check the solutions that are in the notes. And so that's where all of this stuff is. I try to be very detailed here in my solutions, showing all the different steps so that way you can hopefully understand kind of exactly how I went through each and every part of a question. In addition to the lecture guides and lecture notes, though, you know, how are we going to move through those? That's with the lecture videos. And all of those videos are here in this folder. They're broken down by different sections, and each one of those sections is broken up into different parts, so it's easy for you to go back and kind of rewatch portions of a video that you might need when it comes time to study, or you need to review an idea, or maybe something was just confusing the first time through. Okay. Also in here, after you've gone through the notes, you've watched all the videos, it's going to be really important that you practice with worksheets. And worksheets are not taken for a grade, but they're here to help. And so I've gone ahead and posted a bunch of practice problems. That's what these worksheets are. Say here for section 2.1. And so you see here I got a nice blank space on each one of these problems for you to go through and try to work them. But then in addition to that, I've included full worked out solutions. So that way you can go, oh, okay, how does my answer compare to the actual answer? And, you know, is there something I missed? Is there something I need to work on or practice? And again, this is crucial because you want to make sure that you're doing this before you go work on homeworks, or definitely before you go into an exam. This is what's going to allow you to make sure that you're really practiced and you know what you're doing. And I've tried to include, again, a worksheet here for every single one of the sections that we talk about. And so hopefully you can make sure that you are really well-practiced before it comes time for homeworks and exams. So hopefully that gives you a little bit of an idea of where to find all the different information related to each individual unit, so you can go ahead and hit the ground running and stay on pace with the calendar this semester.